It's the David, don't let them eat. They won't eat tonight.
Nobody there.
Don't eat anymore, because you're gonna eat at a restaurant, okay?
Well, you should give me his number when I'm out there. Give him a call.
How you doing? Leave it.
Younger than me.
That's how it usually is, like, right there. It's rare that we go on working days.
It's a little bit of Christmas.
Yeah.
I can't remember what it is. Because I have three of them. Well, no, I'll find out. She'll be back from work on Monday. Daddy? There. There.
No, I only did. I mean, the center court was, all the way up there.
Stacy.
Turn around.
Yeah, but David's living.
Yeah, these are the ones that are down there.
Well, you have it in your house, I'll take it at your house.
I could be on that Friday, but I would prefer to be on that.
Yeah, I know, I'm trying to talk all about that last year. It's long.
Yeah, we don't have it.
This is strong.
Blueberries, everybody in this middle. But was it trees or bushes?
Usually they're
tree. Usually they're on bush.
Yeah.
The tree.
Usually they are on bushes.
Maybe it's a really big blueberry tree.
Right, maybe it was an old blueberry tree. But we can't stand underneath this. We gotta go someplace else. Because we're squashing them all over the place. I know, right. You get all that blue all over yourself.
The only thing was the plant. And my friend is getting.
Good, how you been?
Good, how about yourself? Hey, how's been your home?
Hi, Jade.
We had a lot of problems.
Yeah.
Get a wave to me? Hi.
Yeah, I heard.
Oh, to you too.
How bad?
Another one. Give Daddy a kiss.
That wasn't the major problem. The major problem is that. Kicked in and he didn't get that balance.
Two or three houses were closed.
Time to pay $220.
Whenever I get enough money, which will be never.
Well, I know.
She looks just like a girl. Surely never put a crown on her. Oh, yeah, he's so.
She just loves one day.
Flash on there?
Sorry, Ed.
How is this picture?
I think that's more for outdoors. Because it's kind of around this view.
Yeah, it's so flash.
Yeah, we're gonna eat dinner, we're gonna eat,
Here, Remy, use my camera. Remy, use my camera.
Please go real quick.
Use my camera. Oh, thanks.
Do you want some chocolate?
No, need to do it.
Here, Remy.
You know where they are. Whoa, Plum. Wait, take the cap off. Take a picture of, let me see.
Quiet.
Cheese.
Cheese.
Which one's your?
Too late.
See, that was good.
No, I'm fine, thank you.
I got him at the sunglasses. Me too?
Hey Dave, get her.
Come here. Take a picture with me.
Cheese.
Come on, take a picture with Jamie.
Cheese. Hurry up.
Take a picture of Jamie over here.
Take a picture of Jay.
Look at Remy.
He was steady though.
Look at Greg. Jane, are you hungry still?
Can I have your autograph?
Thank you.
I need more light in here for you guys, I know that.
You didn't really want to see you suck your finger.
Oh, man, she scared me the one time.
Show Aunt Nellie how you suck your fingers.
Where's Bob and Susie?
The other ones.
Steve was bringing them
show
here.
Show her. How you doing?
I know. Suzanne wanted to get a panoramic Fuji. I know. I think that's why. I wouldn't
show it. Show it now. How you doing?
That's what
you're
shooting with.
Oh. Say hi, Stacy.
That's for a group shot.
Oh, no. I said hi to Stacy. You're in. Stacy, we'll see you.
Stacy. Wish you were here. What?
She loves the little baby hot dogs. Look at her face.
Okay.
What?
What's this? Turn around. My cousin Dina from my mother's side. His brother Matthew. This is Kevin. Stacy. Looks like Linda.
Michael
and Greg and David.
Those are old pictures, huh?
They have these pictures. There's Greg, Stacy, and Kevin.
Here's your dad.
Here's
Uncle show
George.
Shirley. She hasn't seen Dad before. Here's Shirley. Come here.
Here's my dad over here.
Where's that
chocolate?
He did see my
dad
right
here.
JJ.
I'm
so funny. Oh, okay, because inside there is a
book. That flower is
when I got my book. Nice time.
Which one? Flower. Yes, it does. It looks like, what do they call an Irish?
Do
doing?
It's all right.
It
almost looks like,
Is that a movie camera?
No, that's...
It's a camcorder. So that was the main...
I've always wanted one of those.
Can you turn the light on?
But I think my...
What? I can turn the light on, yeah.
My smoke here, see your cute little girl.
These are just... Better fix.
Well, it's like the automatic.
Oh, is it? Well, how can you light the lights now?
Well, I guess it's getting enough light.
I leave it here, so whenever any young children come, they have something to play with.
Well, that's too dark.
That's just the angle. I turn it like that, it is.
Well, maybe he needs his boo-boo to keep that on.
You can take that off. That's okay.
Chad, put that on.
Yeah.
Whoa, all that information, PM 8031, T-30-75.
Yeah, that's not gonna show, I mean, this'll be on it. Cause I left it on there, but this is just information, so I know how many minutes I've got left.
She could be a doctor, that's what I just changed.
Tattoo people, it's for the system.
Oh, that's good sense.
Anything you want.
Isn't it nice?
Yes, we went to get one of these panoramic cameras, because I wanna be able to get everybody in on time.
Did you find a place to get?
Yeah, we went to Walmart. The shopping center right back there.
That's not a panda bear.
But Bobby likes the Fuji's better, and he's been disappointed, he had to get a Kodak.
That's a panda bear over there, it's a black and white bear.
Fuji's are so good, and they're less expensive.
I never bought panoramic, excuse me.
Oh, I love it, because you can get everything. That CMI got a great...
This is a Fuji. This is a Fuji panoramic one.
Oh, this is nice.
Save that for the archives.
Yeah.
Important footage. This is important footage here. Historical.
Okay.
That's pretty neat.
Why is it dark? Yeah, let there be light.
Historical value. Stephen drinking coffee.
Karen coming down the stairs.
Here I come.
What else do you guys do?
Golf and what else?
Boo! Look at Karen.
We took one of these boats that goes down and you kayak off the back of the boat.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
This is a great shot.
The boat? That was another kayak where you throw them the camera and they take the picture.
Great shot. I love it. What is it? A glacier behind you?
Yeah.
It's wonderful. I love your picture.
It's hard to tell, but that glacier is like a football field tall.
No, I would be like, I can't even...
Suzanne, hold it up.
Would you go back there again? Would you choose that?
Suzanne, hold it up.
I'd like to see other parts of this thing.
Hold it up.
Mommy will put it away.
Rummy?
Can you see it? Where is it? I can't find, locate it.
It is. I'll just take a close up of it, Allie.
That's what I'm trying to. I gotta locate it.
It's like 10 feet tall, but it's really like 200 feet tall.
Oh, okay.
It is beautiful.
You can't see that on the phone.
You wanna make a bet?
Yeah.
Come over here.
But it's too dark, isn't it?
No.
Yeah, she comes right.
Very great.
No, stay back. You can spread it here further back.
Okay.
Well, I got a zoom. I can zoom.
No, stay back. Come close.
She was on the side with
it. Did you see that?
I don't know.
Impervious to sunburns. It's not.
What do you say, Angel?
Well, we'll
Repeat the clock.
Well, honey, can you show us the truth? Ask for me. He knows where it is. Hold it with your hands. That's okay. We'll wipe that up. No problem.
Oh, you've got to shake it.
Hold it. Shake the rest. Shake the rest. Okay, now the cup is on top, right? Oh, we have to see. That's right. And you can put it in the refrigerator when you finish, okay?
Rev, I think Gum Gum has it just right. We had it sort of shuffle them around a little bit.
Okay, I think they're
down there. I told them
they're all hooked up. They can't find any other place, but that's all right. Now.
But okay, I bet you could go down
to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Time to rest.
Hey, you!
listen to those at home.
There's before it died, right?
Oh, no.
She goes, because that party was late.
Well, the Texas side. I know, we're going round and round. Mom's better now. Okay, you all right? Are you better?
My whole body
put your arm around the big light, and you wrote it. York down to 42nd Street. Right. The building used to take about, I think, 50 cents or a dollar. And he could buy newspaper for a penny a piece and sell them. The price of the newspaper was 2 cents, but we used to get a nickel for it. What he'd do is Perry, you take 3rd Avenue, and you should say, Georgie, you take 2nd Avenue, Bobby, you take 1st Avenue, and Eddie wasn't quite old enough at that time, so Eddie didn't do it yet. So we'd come down those streets selling. By the time we got to 79th Street, we'd all be out of newspapers. And then we also had a problem with another, you know, Irish kids that used to fight for one and say, hey, you guys, get out of here. So Bill started fighting with one of them. I said, Fegan, but Fegan, the Fegan boys. And so we had a mix up on that. But then we'd go back on down to 42nd Street, get some more newspapers, go to 79th Street, come back and sell more. Well, he saw us, he didn't think, he knew we were selling newspapers. So he didn't think we were selling So he let us do it. We take the train up to 86 feet.
I just got old, put it to my mouth.
We start from 86 feet on down. Willie had Lexington Avenue, Perry had 3rd Avenue, Perry had 2nd Avenue, I had 1st Avenue.
I told you I went.
I went to the old York film neighborhood, and I went up to the end of the 70s, and just sat on the bench there, and this old man is sitting there, gray old man, he was like, maybe he was like 70 or so. And he seemed like a nice guy, and I said, oh, my dad used to live around here. And he says, your dad used to live around here. He said, when was that? I said, oh, well, I guess it was about, you know, at the time I was 21. So I said, oh, I guess that was about at least 25 years ago. So he says, you mean all those Chinese kids running around?
Right, right in the neighborhood, right over there, you guys must have stood out, that's why. Street, the dead end there, across there was the black and white building, you know who used to live in there was Sydney Greenstreet.
Oh, she doesn't know, the famous guy in the Maltese ball, big heavy set guy, and he lived there, and then across the street from there
was what we call the old bakery.
The old bakery, that's where Frank Sinatra has his luxury apartment, that luxury apartment, that used to be a bakery.
It was an old deserted bakery,
right.
And there used to be about three or four floors. If you could find your way, you know, if you look on 71st Street, okay?
I'm tired too, but I'm still here.
You're way down the basement of this bakery, but there was no way to get in there. It was all stone. So it's high above the East River, so you can watch the East River. And it had all the grading for it. We used to play baseball in there. That one doesn't seem like it, but what we did is we would watch and stand in one location so that in order not to lose
boxing.
The ball, okay, a hard ball.
They're watching boxing.
We would hit the wall, and we had a painted line in front of it. If your ball went above that line, it was considered a home run.
Right. Over the wall.
But a lot of guys used to go into the old bakery.
I love it.
And they used to try to cook potatoes, stuff like that. And, was, and that's how I broke my wrist. I fell off the stone wall.
Oh my gosh.
And on the other side was a milk container. And what it did was
just
hit the wrong way. And I wound up to the New York hospital. Boy, was mom pissed. She did not want me to go to the hospital. I forget what was the reason.
It costs money to go to the hospital.
Huh?
It costs money to go to the hospital.
Well, yeah, but she made me change her clothes and put on old clothes.
She wanted you to go to the clinic.
It was something like that. She said,
something like that.
I want to go to the clinic. Don't go to emergency. I went to emergency and I was, before you know it, I was somewhere on the 12th floor, you know, getting a cast.
That's Lucille. No, that's my dad. This is Lucille on the right and my mom on the left.
The reason I think mom was sick was because I didn't go to the clinic. I just didn't
do it. Bobby, did your mother name you?
I don't know.
Did you guys ever get out of the city, like fresh air fund or anything like that? I did.
I'll see it again.
Everybody, did you deliver his shirts?
It was delivered to Ted Kennedy, Amber? Yeah.
And then in his living room, he had a big bowl where he had coins in it. And he says, go help yourself.
Oh, wow.
So I tried to put my hand in it because I couldn't see inside. So I wanted to put my hand in there, pull up some coins, and I put it in my pocket. He says, you get enough of it. No. And I get my hand in there again, and I take some more coins. So what happened was, I guess on Halloween or Thanksgiving, I'm not sure which day. Halloween or Thanksgiving,
right.
He used to go to the roof with this big bowl of coins. And he looked down and said, hey, kids! You know, we'd all look up, and we'd be playing, you know, ball on the street or something like that. And he'd take the whole bowl of coins and throw it out.
No way! Yeah.
And we were picking up quarter out of
the street. That's all over the street. That's pennies from heaven. Pennies, literally.
And you know.
Tell them about the lady, the beer lady, that took her beer up in a bucket.
Oh, Mrs. Hannigan.
Mrs. Hannigan?
Mrs. Hannigan used to live on the top floor in the same thing tenement house. So before she would go upstairs. I mean, when she used to come down, she used to leave the bucket with mom in the laundry. And it was back in the old days. You had a bucket with a gray wire and a cover, and it didn't have cans and it didn't have bottles. So you got your beer in the bucket to take home. So anyway, what she'd do, when we'd be playing on the street, she'd yell, hey boy, you know, would you give me some beer, you know, go up the street and get the beer, which is where the Johnny Cadden bar was.
You know, right
by
on
that,
the corner.
In the old days, it was just a corner bar.
Right.
And she'd throw it down in the newspaper, wrapped it in the newspaper, something like about 80, 90 cents or something like that. And down it, you know, she'd go up there. But I hated it because when you got the beer, first of all, you can't hold it correctly.
Right.
Even though you have a cover, you know, sure as hell don't want to spill it.
Right.
And, but the damper used to run right through your fingers. You're just a little kid, a little thing. And you got to go up 8 flights of stairs.
Yeah.
And all she'd give you was something like a nickel tip or a dime.
Those days, nickel was a lot of money. Yeah. Right.
So So that's Mrs. Hannigan. That's what she was.
Do you remember Mrs. O.O. McIntyre?
Yeah.
I remember George mentioning McIntyre.
You remember?
Was she a sponsor to somewhere?
O.O. McIntyre? I don't know if she was from the John Holt crew or not. I know there's women, like the women who became your godmothers, our godmothers.
Well, I don't know where Mom found this people.
I know, seriously. I really don't.
What are you doing tonight?
She found all the philanthropists associations in that city. And that's the top people. Mrs. O.O. McIntyre used to have a Rolls Royce. Rolls Royce with a chauffeur in the front, you know, like a no hood on it, and then a hood to the back. This was an old Rolls Royce. And every Christmas, she used to come around and pick us all up. It was like, whoever was home. I rarely remember.
Where did she take us?
She took us sightseeing all around the city. She would take us down Wall Street. She showed us, I remember there was a clock down on Wall Street. She always showed us.
Where did she take you?
That's so nice.
You don't remember? She always took us to Hornet Hardart.
Oh.
And we could get whatever we wanted out of the little
automatic,
the slot.
For 5 cents.
It was so strange because Mrs. Kelly did the same thing, but Mrs. Kelly instead, it was just me and Eddie at the time.
Uh-huh.
She took us to Schraff's.
Mm-hmm. Ice cream.
And we used to say, whoa.
we're doing good today.
She used to live in the Plaza Hotel. And at the Plaza at the same time used to live Herbert Hoover. He was retired. He was gone, you know, like out of office. And he was just aging and that was his
Who was this?
This is O.O. McIntyre. Then one time I started to think, who is this woman?
Get her crawling away.
Yeah, right, that was here.
One round.
Mingus every other fight.
Huh?
Yeah. Mingus every other fight.
Mingus like the fourth
fight? Unless they knock it out early or something. Yeah.
You can push the thing and you can up
it. And he certainly started to do what you suggested. When he was landing those great rights to the body, you said he was going to come
your
up.
Your mom is learning what happened.
He has made that
change. Oh, bullshit.
Well, you know what happened? One Christmas, my Georgetown is left on that.
Oh, no.
My girlfriend came over to the city and I had to
so that long means long it's going to be gone?
Well, I have another film. And this is how all the batteries are fixed. So, you give you a warning of blood down.
I don't think so.
Yeah.
I didn't touch any of that.
Okay.
Burger.
I don't know.
Is it good?
Yeah. All I remember is that when I looked her up, you know that she was the wife of a editor in chief of the New York Times.
O.O.
McIntyre.
They knew all rich people.
That's what I said. I didn't know that.
You were a kid.
No, we didn't know who they were.
I know.
But there is, like, I don't know if you ever watch A&E.
Yeah, I do.
And you ever watch about the Carnegies and the, not the Rockefellers, them too, but the Vanderbilts from
Staten Island.
The Vanderbilts. Well, a lot of those mansions up on Fifth Avenue, if you walk around,
the
are great. are their kids, their grandkids.
Yeah.
You know, and a lot of, like the Frick Museum. I didn't know Frick was part of the
originally part of the
Carnegie Mellon. That whole era, and that Frick Mansion is only filled with all of his traveling antiques that he picked up.
But we felt, and we were dead end kids, and that rich thing we always.
But Eddie said when he remembered when he was young, he took on one of the big elevators and was focused on a real plush apartment and stuff like that. But the everyone like befriended the little junk kids, I guess, right?
They were so cute. Yeah.
But I never understood. There was, they had these like Auntie Mame, you have that apartment where you have a double floor.
That's what Eddie was talking about, with an elevator that goes up.
Oh, they had the round stairs too.
We probably need like 10 cameras.
There,
what?
The bedrooms
we probably need 10 cameras.
Was the kitchen, dining room, and the living room, and also where either the maid lived.
Get us a tape too.
The chauffeur.
We'll make a copy.
Yeah.
So you went in there, it's like they used to say, I used to deliver the laundry there. And so I delivered the laundry, and the maid would then give me a coat. And I sat there in the kitchen, and I looked up on the wall, and I said, what are those numbers for? 1, 2, 3, 4. And she said, well, one is for the maid, two is for the... for the cook or whatever, and three was for the chauffeur, and four was for somebody else, okay? That's exactly what it was. And that's old money. That's the Connecticut, upstate New York old money that lived up on Park Avenue or whatever that street was. And believe it or not, what I could never figure out is, why the hell did they bring laundry all the way down to 72nd Street?
What are you doing now?
I missed it too. Start it again.
In the basement was a bowling alley. Okay.
Where? At Jones Memorial?
John Hall Memorial.
At John Hall.
And down there, this was unbelievable. I never found a church like this. I mean, it had bowling alleys and all this sort of stuff.
It must have been because of all the wealthy influence. They probably had huge contributions to a lot of the family.
Yeah, because this was a very strange church. In fact, I became a choir boy. And I was, I had to be in the choir. And I never was so embarrassed because I didn't have white socks and didn't have black socks at one point in time. And I forget why, for some reason or other, I had to wear that big white smock with the red smock over that, okay, and the black top. But I had yellow socks.
What about your brothers? Did they go to the...
The only other one who was in the choir with me was Ed. I don't think Perry or Georgie or Willie was in the choir.
Are they the one that put you in, that helped you through your Zen's point, or what if they made that
list? King's
point?
Yeah.
Kelly was the one that helped you through
the ladies?
I had to do that myself.
Why did you go about that? Yeah, but wasn't it Kelly who helped get the
appointment?
No.
Not the appointment, but help put together some of the people to it was Miss Kelly who...
No, I didn't do it at all. When I was at Brooklyn Tech, I had taken the exam to the school, to King's Point, but I had also applied for City College, I also applied for Brooklyn College. So, and then I also went to Fashion Institute of Technology, which was over in 23rd, something like that.
West Side, right.
And that scared me. I mean, I don't know, I was, you know, I took the test, and the whole class was all girls. I was the only boy there.
You were ahead of your time.
And so I was scared to hell. I said, oh my God. And then there's one little girl next to me. I mean, she was fumbling with her exam and everything. And I could never put my name on my exam, but I did all the questions. So what I did is I slipped in my exam and took hers.
Oh,
and,
why would you do that?
And I put all the wrong answers on and put my name on it.
Okay, you didn't want to go.
I didn't want to go.
What were you going to do?
Different, okay, for fabric and how you can make different designs for it. That's what. So I took the exam there, and even though, you know, I got a notice that said, you know, you're accepted to the.
Your husband's very tired.
Yeah, I'm tired. I was going to read a book, but I went for a walk home by accident.
Bobby, tell me again, how did George break his nose? I missed that.
We were playing basketball, and the gym was up on the top floor of the church. So after we were finished playing basketball, I forget who else was it. It was a couple of kids.
No, I'm fine.
We were all in the locker room, and what we wound up doing is we were hiding from the drunk guy. So what happened was George went up on top of one of the lockers. So he's, you know, running across the locker. All of a sudden, the locker started coming down, so he jumps down.
They started tipping?
Yeah, he
had two black eyes. You know, both of his eyes were black.
Two cans of dye.
Apparently, when he came down, the damn thing on the edge of the locker hit him, rather than, you know.
Well, she think you should drive as hard as you are, Eileen? Georgie?
Yeah, I know he got a deviated septum or something from that, too.
Yeah.
Huh? Get him some coffee. You didn't want to, I asked him.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, but Mary and
Linda. Yep. We're heading out.
You're heading out.